Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello students, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Today I am going to start microcontroller and embedded system laboratory experiment details, that is 18 CSL 48 of VTU fourth semester CS and IS syllabus. So what is the prerequisite for this lab? Before starting this lab, you should have some knowledge about the certain things. So what is that? That is called as a prerequisite. So in VTU 18 CSL 48 syllabus of fourth semester CS and IS, this lab contains 16 experiments, 8 experiments are software experiments and remaining 8 experiments are hardware interface experiments. That means software experiments we will execute by writing code in assembly language or embedded C language and using simulation software such as MicroVision Keil. Second one is hardware experiment. We use the hardware, we write the program in embedded C and we will interface the hardware to LPC2148 kit and we will try to execute the experiment to achieve the desired result. So as a prerequisite, we should know what is a microcontroller and what is a microprocessor. First of all, what is a microprocessor? We know microprocessor is an integrated circuit which contains ALU and a control unit which stores a set of instruction and which executes the instruction with the help of ALU and a control unit one by one to achieve the desired task. Now what is a microcontroller? Microcontroller, you can see here, microcontroller is a compact integrated circuit designed to govern specific operation in embedded system. A typical microcontroller includes a processor, memory, input output device on a single chip. So in our lab experiment we are using ARM7 based LPC218 microcontroller from NXP Philips. So this is the ARM7 based LPC2148 microcontroller which contains 64 pins and this is a surface mounting device and this package is known as a quad plat package. So this is the difference between a microcontroller and a microprocessor. So in our lab we are using this microcontroller. This microcontroller contains ARM7 based core along with that flash ROM, memory, etc. On continuing the discussion, so how we will program these microcontroller? We will write the program here by using a software called as Keil. It is a MicroVision 3 or 4 or 5 version is available in the market. It is an integrated development environment for Windows based software development platform. This combines editor, project manager and other facilities. By using this software, we write the program either in assembly language or in embedded C language. So now, what are the main features of the Keil version 4 or 5? The main features is it contains code editor, it contains device database, project manager where you can manage your projects, then facility for assembling, compiling and linking your embedded applications, then dialog settings, then integrated source level debugger and graphic development interface. All these things are there in MicroVision 4. Now the first experiment is of 18 CSL 48 syllabus of VTU for fourth semester CS and IS students of CS and IS branch. So we have the first experiment is a 16-bit multiplication. The algorithm for this code, this one is, it's just like I will take the two numbers I will take in the register 1 and register 2, and I will multiply these two numbers and I will store the result in register 0. Before that, to have more information on register, I will take you to now ARM architecture. So now ARM architecture, you can see here. First of all, let me explain you about ARM pin configuration. So this is the ARM pin configuration. You can see here, as I told earlier, LPC21480 is a microcontroller based on ARM7 TDMI core, which contains 64 pins. It is a 64-pin quad flat package. You can see 64 pins on all sides here. But you can see some of the pin has got only one functionality. Some pins have got multiple functionality. That is, you take the pin number 1 here, which this has got four functionalities. That is, first one is it acts like general purpose input output pin, then second alternative, then third alternative, then fourth alternative. Like that, we have several pins with the four alternatives. Now the question is, what is the use of these alternatives functionality? The use is LPC 2140 is 2148 is a low power consumption microcontroller from NXP based on ARM7 TDM. Low power consumption is possible only when number of gates are less in the design. How you can design a IC with the more functionality with the having less number of gates is by assigning multiple functionality to the single pin. For example, if you take this pin number 1, then at a certain point it acts like pin number 0.21 GPIO. That is the first alternative, or it can act at a point with second alternative, or it can act at a point third alternative or fourth alternative. Like this, four functionalities are assigned to this pin. So by having multiple functionalities, will reduce the number of extra pins required for this package, which in turn result in low power consumption. Now we'll see the architecture of ARM7. The architecture of ARM7, you can see here, this will, in this architecture, you can see various functional blocks. Normally, instruction is fetched from the memory. Suppose, if you think, here is the memory. Here is the memory, then it will fetch the instruction from the memory. Instruction contains data as well as instruction. So instruction moves here to the instruction decoder. Instruction decoder will analyze the instructions, and based on the analysis, it will give various signal to the ALU and other units. And data moves to the sign extent, where depending on the sign bit, suppose if the data is 8 bit or 16 bit, then it will be extended to 32 bit. The 32 bit data are stored in these registers. We have a register file which contains normally 37 register. At a time, 16 registers are visible. So R0 to R15 is the register. It is visible in normally user mode. So from the register, the data moves to ALU, and from the register, data moves through ALU either by means of two operands. One operand is taken through barrel shifter. So the main use of the barrel shifter is to improve the performance. Other than that, we have here something called as multiple and accumulate. This is also used to improve the performance. And finally, after the execution, the result is stored in register file. From our register file, the result is transmitted once again to memory. So please remember, my dear students, there are only two instructions, load instructions and store instruction, which deals with memory. Other than that, all the instructions are executed in registers only. That's why ARM7 is a performance based processor. That means it will give very good performance because here the architecture is rigid. It has got rigid architecture. All the instructions executions will take place in the register only. And we know, according to the fast theory, that register execution is faster than memory. So ARM depends on 90% of the time register, not on memory. Suppose if you compare same thing with Intel, Intel design is flexible oriented. That means it works on both memory and register. That's why we cannot expect good performance as ARM in Intel. In our ARM architecture is rigid and the performance will get better. So this is called as a bank register or a programmer's model, and this will give the idea about how the different registers are used in different operating modes. So there are 7 operating modes. In the user and system modes, we have 16 registers along with the CPSR, current program status register. Other than that, you will come to know later. Other than that, we have different modes and we have different registers in different modes. So in normal mode or user mode and system mode, we have 16 registers R0 to R15. Out of that, R0 to R8 is known as general purpose registers. Other than that, you can see here R13 is called as stack pointer register, R14 is called as link register, R15 is called as program counter, and CPSR means current program status register, which gives the indication about different flags or status of different flags and operating modes, status of operating modes, and information related to interrupt and fast interrupt. So now moving on to our programs. As I said, we are taking two numbers. One number is stored in register 1 and second number is stored in register 2, and the result is stored in register 0. So now we will see the program. So here the first sentence is always ARM programs, assembly language program, starts with the TTL. It is optional. TTL indicates the title of the program. So title, I have given 16 bit multiplication. Second one is area. Area indicates the program where I am going to write the program. The area where I am going to write the program. And you can give the name to this area. Like in this case, it is given program 1. You can give any name. And this program is nothing but it is a code related to code, and finally it is mapped to read-only memory. So starting of the program is indicated by entry. Now here you can see I have mentioned data in the data segment, something like this. Here you can see I have initialized separate segment area, and that is data 1. The label given to area, and that this contains data, and that is the read only. So I have taken two numbers here, 16 bit numbers I have taken. You see, these are the 16 bit numbers, and the name label given to these numbers is num1 and num2, because computer works on address, but we can't remember address. That's why we have to give the label. So label is given, and I am using here some assembler directive that is called as a define constant word. Define constant word means it allocates 2 bytes of memory, and the memories are aligned with the 2 bytes. Normally, ARM is 32-bit, 4-bit memory locations. It will take 4-bit memory location at a time. But in case, you cannot expect always your data can be 32-bit. Your data can be 16-bit also, 8-bit also. That time, you have to instruct the assembler. That is called as assembler directive by using word DCW. That indicates you have used half words, not full words. Here, full words means 32 bits. Half word means 16 bit. So now, you can see here, I have taken the number. I have loaded the number in register R1. LDRH means load register half words. Load register half words, second number. Then I will multiply using MUL instruction. Please remember, our ARM is a triadic instruction. ARM supports triadic instruction. Triadic instruction means, here you can see three operands are there. MUL R0, R1, R2. That doesn't mean that I am multiplying R0, R1 and R2. I multiply R1 and R2 and the result is stored in R0. So this has got several advantages. We'll see that later. Followed by stop B stop. Stop B stop means I will make the program counter to loop here only without executing unwanted codes after this one, or I will make program counter to stay here only. So this is the program. Now after this we will see how we can execute the program. Let me start kill software. I have kill microvision 4. So let me start kill microvision 4. So you can see here kill microvision 4 is open. So, in Kill Microvision 4, so first you have to open the new project. If any project is opened, that you have to close it initially. So here, I can see none of the project is opened. So I will start directly new project, new microvision project. In new microvision project, I will give the name. It is better to start a different project and better to, different project for different experiment and better to store all these different experiments in different projects in different folder. So here I will give the project name, for example, test1 test1.proj project, test1 project. Before that, what I will do is, I will create the folder on desktop. The folder is my folder is test1, test1. So in test1, I will create the project and I will save the project. After that, I will select the target. Target in my case is NXP, that is, we are going to use NXP LPC2148 controller. So LPC2148 controller, you have to select here LPC2148 controller 2148. So 2148 controller. So this is LPC2148 controller, and LPC2148 controller, you can see here. So LPC2148 controller, you can see the information of the LPC2148 controller. It is a ARM7TDMI. ARM7TDMI means T means thumb mode, D means debugging, and M means long multiply. And I means something related to interrupt based, something like that. So ARM7TDMI, It is a based high performance 32-bit RISC RISC microcontroller. It is a reduced instruction set computing microcontroller, and it contains 512 KB on-chip flash ROM. Other than that, it has in-system programming capabilities. Other than that, it has contained 10-bit ADCs, analog to digital controller with 14 channels, and it supports USB 2 full speed device controller. Then it has got two UHARTs, universal asynchronous receiver transmitter with one full modem interface. Then it has got two serial interface, two 32-bit timers, watchdog timer, and other than that, real time clock, general purpose input output pins, CPU clock up to 60 megahertz. All these informations are very important. These are the technical details of this LPC2148 controller. Now select LPC2148 here, then click on OK. So here it will pop up to copy startup files. Startup files contain some library related files. These files are required when you program, when you use embedded system programming by using embedded C language. That time you need startup dot yes, otherwise this file is not required for when you write the program by using assembly language. So I will click on no. That time it will create, here you can see it will create the, it has created the target. So under target 1, if you click here, under target 1 it has created the source group 1. My next job is to create the file. To create the file, I have to click on file, new Microvision file. This is the new Microvision file. So now this is the project window, this is the text editor, and this is the output window. So first let me write the program. I have already explained you the program. Let me write the program. So here you can see the file, a particular program to add to multiply two numbers. After writing the program, you have to save the program. To save the program, you have to click here and you have to save the program. Once you save the program, you have to add this file to this group, source group. To add this file to the source group, double click on the source group. Either you can double click or you can add a right click source group and add files to the source group. And here you have to search the file. So in my case, it is a ASM assembly language file. So this is the file. So I will select the file and click on add, close. Now the file is added. You can see the file is added. Once the file is added, then finally save the file. Now you have to compile the file. To compile the file, click this one, this icon, or this button. So it will compile the file, and you should get zero errors and zero warnings. After the compiling file, you have to build it and rebuild it. So once this is done, after that, next job is, you have already compiled the file. Next job is you have to debug it and you have to check the output. For that, we have here something called start and stop debug session, or we have short key here. So click on this one. When you click on debug, it says like it is a evaluation mode. Evaluation mode means it is not the paid one. It is the software is not the paid one. Software is it is a evaluation mode. It is used for used normally for education institution, and maximum size of the code you can write is here is 32 kilobytes. That's all. So click on OK. So now you can see the different windows. Here it is a register window, and here it is a disassembly window, and it is here your program window, and it is here output window and memory window. So five types of windows you can see here. Let me repeat, register window, you can see a register contents. Disassembly window. Disassembly window means your program, you write the program by using opcode, but internally it is analyzed in some other way. Inside the processor, it is analyzed in some other way. That is called as this opcode. Your opcode is disassembled into binary or object, this one code. That is this disassembly window. And next one is our program window, then output window, and memory window. So let me execute the program one by one. So I will click on this button, step by step execution. Either you can execute step by step or you can execute at once. I will click on step by step. So when you click here, first number is loaded. This is the this one code. Yeah, program counter is here. You can see the program counter is here. It has executed already first one. It has taken number one and is loaded in the register one. I will click on once again F11. So second number is loaded. Then I will click on this one. Third, that is, it will multiply two numbers and this is the multiplied value. You can check this one using by calculator in a scientific calculator, and you can check whether the numbers multiplied are correct or not. The answer is correct or not. After that, if you click this button again and again, then there is no further execution because the program counter is pointing to this unconditional branch instruction. B means unconditional branch. Unconditional branch followed by label. So branch, label, stop. So that means it will branch to stop. Where is the stop? Stop is here. So it will come here once again and it will loop here only. Program counter loop here only. So this is the first experiment, my dear students. So I will in the next session I will take the second experiment. Till then, bye bye.